The trio, including Betty Cheretich, 31, the late's wife, Martin Kipsang, 42, and Joshua Namurenge, 36, have been further remanded by Selsa Biwanga, the Masindi Grade 1 magistrate, who sat in for Kosia Kasibayo, the chief magistrate. The case had come for mention, but this did not happen because Kasibayo, the trial magistrate, is on leave. Alganyira Munandura Arenitwe, the state prosecutor, informed court that inquiries are still ongoing and asked for an adjournment. The trio allegedly murdered Abiriga on January 7th, 2024, at his home in Kijura, North Central Division in Masindi District. Preliminary investigations indicate that the murder was not only a premeditated act, but also involved a sinister plot orchestrated by the widow, Betty Cheretich, who allegedly hired contract killers to carry out the crime. Investigations further indicate that the motive behind the murder was rooted in a marital discord, jealousy, and suspicion of infidelity. Meanwhile, the National Unity Platform has dragged the government to court demanding for the release of all political prisoners. Members of the opposition National Unity Platform claim that 18 of their members are still unaccounted for. With over 30 people who included wives, children and other relatives, they camped at the Constitutional Court where they filed a petition against the government of Uganda demanding for the release of their people. Some of the people have been allegedly missing since 2021.
My husband was among the people that were saying that they don't exist or they traveled abroad. This is the passport of my husband and this is the national ID. I think he's a Ugandan. There is no way this can exist when you're not there. So this proves that Chibalama John Bosco is a
Kwago Martin, who was adopted on the 23rd of November 2020. Since now, I'm still looking for him. I've gone everywhere looking for him. I even have the references from Ginger Road. They even tried to bring someone whom I don't know, claiming that he's Kwago Martin. But since now, I've not seen my husband. I'm still looking for him.
These were led by the leader of opposition in parliament, Joel Senyonyi, the party spokesperson, Lewis Rubongoya, as well as lawyer George Musisi.
We visited a suit where we are seeking government to account. We are seeking that court orders government to account for each of these people. We know that there has been a lot of disinformation and misinformation from different institutions, including the Uganda Human Rights Commission, including statements read in Parliament, where even the existence of these people was being doubted by some state agencies. So this case has been instituted in the names of all the missing persons and also their relatives.
This issue, there's been many attempts to try and cause us to drop the ball, plus the families, to try and slow us down in demanding for these missing persons. They've done all manner of things. Initially, they said these people don't exist.
Many of these people have court orders, have what we call habeas corpus orders. There's one for Damulira John, there's one for Kanata Muhammad, there's one for Sempi Jayuda. All those people got orders for their release, but those orders were not respected by the regime. So what we are trying to do here is to bring yet another case.
The file has been allocated to Justice Esther Nambayo, who has fixed 8th April to start hearing the petition. Story compiled by Goodfrey Muhumuza and Rachel Nachwala for the news.